So here at Agility Robotics, we design and develop bipedal robots that do work in the real world. Obviously, the real world is full of unpredictable situations and environments. So we really need Digit to be able to handle those environments smoothly. So in animals, to achieve this sort of compliant behavior and these reflexes, obviously that's been optimized over thousands of years of evolution. Generations and generations of evolution have come to a pretty refined point. With Digit, we can't take advantage of those thousands of years of evolution, but we want to achieve the same animal-like performance. So this compliant behavior with the environment, this ability to react to unexpected disturbances is what we're trying to optimize for, but for us it's a design problem. And what's interesting is if we take that design problem and optimize it, not trying to copy the structure of an animal, but just trying to copy the performance of an animal, we end up with really similar behavior that has sort of these animal-like characteristics. In order to really understand this phenomenon, we can go to a laboratory setting. So here we have a guinea fowl that was basically running down a corridor, and there's this hidden hole in the ground that the experimenters have hidden from the bird. Similarly, we kind of set up the same situation for Digit, and here we can see side by side how they respond to that similar disturbance. So as you can see, in both cases, first the foot slows down, kind of anticipating hitting the ground, and that foot starts to apply forces on the ground, or tries to. But obviously, since there's tissue paper there, it just bursts through the tissue paper and accelerates that foot straight towards the actual ground. Because of that unanticipated disturbance, the foot swings back a bit further than the robot and the bird expects. And you can see that it touches the floor at a point a little bit further back relative to the body than it was planning to. Because it's a little bit further back, that actually pushes the body forward and accelerates the body of both the guinea fowl and the robot forward faster than it expected. Now that the body is moving a little bit faster than it expected, that next step up is like an additional disturbance. And both the bird and the robot have slightly more crouched postures. It does take a few strides after this to slow down again to its nominal speed and also get the body back up to its original height relative to the ground. But what's really important to think about is through all this, it had to do this in, you know, a fraction of the second. It had no idea that that disturbance was there. It had to feel that disturbance with its foot and just reflexually deal with it in a really fast time scale. In the guinea fowl's case, it has generations and generations of evolution that have led it to have this kind of compliant, flexible structure to its leg, and also this like very fast reflexual behavior that can deal with these sudden disturbances. In Digit, it's a robot that we're designing from the ground up. So we have to design those similar compliant elements into its leg, but also we needed to develop software that's able to really quickly react and deal with these disturbances even when things don't go as planned. And really what's unique about our position here at Agility is that we design our software and hardware in a coherent way. So the software is designed keeping in mind that we have this hardware that has these compliant elements, and we take advantage of that in our software in order to deal with these disturbances really smoothly. This approach allows Digit to thrive in a variety of environments and differentiates our product from many other bipedal robots.